It's me again. You might be thinking, "She, aren't you tired? You literally streamed a game for 3 hours and then another game for 30." I say, "Yes, that's true, but I am not tired. I oh my God, Ad, I am running on adrenaline, and also because I have nothing else to do. No, it's because I want to see all the games, and if I don't play them at this rate." Then I won't be able to. You understand? You can't just take things slowly, okay? It's 0 or 100. You either eat until your stomach bursts or you don't eat at all. And by eat, I re mean referring to games. I mean games. Okay. So, but this one is shorter. This one is only like 30 minutes ish long, 30 minutes ish long, because after this I gotta stream on VStream. Here, I'll send a link and then I'll pin it. I gotta stream on VStream because something went wrong. What the hell? Why can't I pin the thing? Okay, there we go. Yeah. So, where I'm just like drawing the thumbnails because I'm gonna have to draw the thumbnails for all these games that I play. Wow! It'll be so much fun! So, that's why. It's a slightly shorter. Also, because I can't. For some reason, all these Spooktober games either like to be 30 minutes long or 3 hours long. So, there's no in between, apparently. Kidding. All right. So, undo the mustache curse, which this is obviously a very big shift in mood from the last game. But basically, my understanding is that the princess has a mustache and it's like a curse or something, and we have to get rid of the mustache. The princess has been mustachioed, and the royal ball is tomorrow to get rid of the unwelcome whiskers. You'll need to track down the witch that cursed her. But monsters lurk upon the path. Yes. And I wrote lesbians and facial hair, but I'm not even sure if they are lesbians, but I'm getting that vibe, so hopefully I'm correct. Okay. And prepare for me to be cringy. Cool. What's extras? Oh, okay, cool. The bouts, credits. Oh, wow, there's a lot of people working on this. Writing. Was to make sure that the comedy didn't derive from woman with facial hair funny and weird. Oh, yeah. Okay, low-key spoiled the ending, but it's fine. Character art. Okay, stop looking at this. She, you need to. I need to go back. How do I go back? Hello? Escape? I guess I can just escape. Alright. My name is Seer. Proud knight serving. Oh, this is the knight. My name is Seer. Proud knight serving Princess Elderflower. And tonight, I'm doing my duty of standing solo guard at the door to her room. This position is a high honor, and one that I don't take lightly. The safety of the princess is paramount. Of course, it makes perfect sense that such an important position would be given to me. I'm great at my job, after all. I love standing and looking at nothing for hours and hours on end. I don't get bored, no way! And I've definitely never fallen asleep on guard duty before. Nightseer! Huh? Really, must they yell? I could have heard them perfectly well at a normal speaking tone. It's not like I was asleep or anything. No, sir. Well, excuse me, Prince. Princess? Oh, man. Also, oops, sorry, that was her speaking. I immediately salute and then do a double take. A princess, what's that on your. What if I give her a British accent? Whatever. She's British now. Not so loud! The princess glances around furtively, but there's no one nearby. I wouldn't I would know. I've been keeping a sharp eye out after all. Yes, because I am a knight and I am on duty and I am definitely watching. Huh? A mustache. Princess, you have to speak up. I can't hear you. It's a mustache, Knight Seer. Oh. Upon closer inspection, this probably should have been obvious, but. Princess, why do you have a mustache? I've been cursed. It's the work of the Witch of the Lake, I'm sure of it. Is that all? It's not a very effective curse. I mean, shave it off and you'll be good as new. She shakes her head. Fine suggestion, but I've already tried that. It grew right back. Oh, you could try waxing it? I'd rather not. It's unlikely waxing will be any more effective, not to mention sounds painful. I see. What do you plan on doing then? Finding the witch and having her lift the cor a curse, of course. Oh, of course. Well, best of luck, princess. I'll need an escort. Oh, who shall it be? Sir Bartimaeus is quite capable, but I think he's off duty tonight. I'd like you to be my escort, Knight Seer. Me? Yes, you. Why me? I'm far less experienced than most other knights. Really, guard duty is where I'm most comfortable. You may be challenged in the application of common sense, but you handle your sword well enough. I've seen it myself. When I've gone and I've seen it when blah, 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 blah. I've seen it myself when I've gone to watch the knights train. And the fewer people who see me in this state, the better. Rumors will quickly start to spread if I'm not careful. That makes sense, I suppose. Then when do we leave?
Immediately.
Right now? But Princess, it's nighttime.
I'm well aware, but we haven't a choice. The royal ball is tomorrow, and my betrothed will be here in the morning to prepare for it.
Ah, she's betrothed. Shut up, she. Okay.
She simply cannot see me like this, and I will not allow it.
Okay, but Princess, you do know there are monsters that roam the woods at this time of night, don't you?
I do. That's why I asked you to be my escort.
Right. Well, if it's the princess asking, I can't afford to let her down. Surely a few little monsters can't be that bad, right? All right, princess. You can count on me to assist you in this matter.
Excellent. Then shall we depart?
Soon, princess. But first, let me take a cell. No. I need to prepare a few things for our journey. I must ask you a question. Ha ha. Har. Har har har. Also, holy shit, this save screen. Wait. What? There's a pause and then save game? What? Dude, I totally was not prepared. I'm so used to my right click just defaulting to save. I guess they changed the mouse input, which is kind of crazy. Okay. But yes, I must ask you a question.
Knight Seer, I must ask you to refrain from making light of my predicament. The situation is stressful enough as is.
Sorry, Princess. Just wanted to lighten the mood.
Well, you didn't.
Ouch. That's uncharacteristically cold for the princess. I must have really upset her. Can I roll back? Oh. I'm just kidding. I never said that. I need to prepare a few things for our journey. It won't do to travel without food or water.
Yes, quite right. I can't be seen, so can I trouble you to gather the supplies for both of us? I'll meet you by the side gate.
Will do, Princess. Be there in a jiffy. After I gather the necessary supplies and meet up with the princess, we set out quietly into the night. The princess leads the way, striding fearlessly into the shadowy forest. I follow just as furiously. Knights aren't afraid of a few shadows, after all. Now, the things that cast the shadows or hide in them, well, those might pose more of a problem. But the princess will run into those first, since she's leading the way, so I'll be fine, totally fine. Princess, where exactly are we headed anyway?
Oh, the witch's favorite bar. It's where we're most likely to find her at this hour.
Favorite bar in the middle of a forest?
Indeed, it's quite a strange location, so I don't think it sees too much patronage. In fact, the witch might be single-handedly responsible for its continued operation.
Wow, she spends that much time and money there. How can she afford it? Isn't she unemployed?
Disa dastardly means. Dastardly means? Dastardly means, I'm sure.
Princess Elderflower waves her hand dismissively.
But that's besides the point. What's important is that... Oh. Ah! Nightseer! What was that?
Well, Princess, in my expert opinion, I'd say it was probably a monster. A shaggy creature lumbers out of the shadows. See, I knew the shadows were bad news. And fixes its glowing eyes upon us. My palms clasped about the hilt of my sword began to sweat. Palms sweaty, knees weak, arms heavy, bottom of my sweater already must begin. The darkness is so deep that I can't even make out the monster's appearance. It's unnerving, not knowing what I'm up against. There's a scraping sound as the creature paws the ground, preparing to charge. I have to fight! Forcing down my fear, I place myself between the monster and the princess. Don't worry, princess. I've done drills for this before.
Right.
The princess backs away, watching with wide eyes. Meanwhile, I throw my sword to the ground.
Nightseer!
And use both hands to dramatically whip off my knight's cape. En guard!
I think it's Ole, actually.
Don't distract me, princess. The beast charges. It's fast, but my reflexes are faster. I dodge and tuck into a neat roll. I pop back up to my feet immediately. Or try to. Only I get a little tangled up in my cape. Happens to the best of us, you know? Those things are really long. No matter. By the time I'm properly on my feet again, the beast is staggering about, stunned after crashing headfirst into a tree. Now is my time to strike! I feel about for my sword on the forest floor, grinning in triumph when my hand closes around the hilt. Take this, foul creature! I charge with a cry, intending to strike the fatal blow!
Huh?
The beast flees into the forest, leaving me staring at the broken branch in my hand in puzzlement.
Looking for this?
Princess Elderflower comes up beside me, offering my sword. My sword! I mean, thank you for fetching it for me. I knew where it was, though. I used the branch on purpose. Highly effective against this type of monster, you know.
Of course. A pine branch, yes? More effective than its close cousin, spruce.
Yes, right. Is the princess laughing at me? I think she's laughing at me.
Come, we're nearly there.
How can you tell?
Listen.
I do, and the sound I hear is truly bone-chilling. Oh no, it's live music night. The princess nods gravely.
Indeed, we best hurry. The less time we have to spend listening to amateur covers, the better.
Oh wow, okay. I love the free background. The atmosphere here is really, The bartender squints suspiciously at us from behind the bar across the room. Which is not very far away, considering how small the place is. On the floor to my right lies a sign that says, "No pets allow." Allow, with no D. The last letter seems to have been chewed off by a pet. And near the back of the room, a very drunk man sporting a very ugly tie and a very gravelly voice sings passionate karaoke. I shudder. He sounds even more inhuman than the monster did. Leave him alone, he's living his best life.
It certainly is something.
Princess Elderflower steps behind me, so close that we're nearly touching. Is she afraid? But she led the way into the forest, and she's well known around the castle for being very social. Then I notice how she ducks her head, trying to hide her face. Of course! How could I forget? It's shocking how quickly I've gotten used to Princess Elderflower's new facial hair. Really, I didn't think it looks half bad on her. I mean, it's all dressed up with a ribbon, too. But I don't think she'd appreciate me saying so. I pick another topic instead. I'm surprised it has any patrons at all, being so deep into the woods.
Well, I suppose the location and the vibe attract a particular crowd.
Do you think that guy knows his mic is unplugged?
Oh, leave poor Harry alone.
Oh, wait. Wait, who is this? Nivien? Leave poor Harry alone. You don't know the half of what he's been through. Instinctively, I take the princess's hand, pulling her close behind me.
You!
So, Princess Elderflower was right about her finding her here, the culprit, in the flesh. Oh! Notorious Witch of the Lake and amateur mustache stylist, Nivien! She steps closer to us, clutching a half-full glass in one hand and looking a bit unsteady on her feet. I love- okay, let me just say, I really like the designs in this game, like, extremely so. It's like, the mustache too, having like a ribbon on it to match with her hair is really, really cute. And then also, the witch hat design is so cool! Okay. But her eyes are clear as they sweep over the two of us. Maybe witches have some resistance to the mental effects of alcohol, or maybe she's stone cold sober and just wants us to believe otherwise. Either way, I can't let my guard down.
Princess Elderflower, it's good to see you, little one. Who's your friend?
Despite the circumstances, Princess Elderflower's voice is steady when she answers.
This is a loyal knight of mine, Nivien. Oh, this is a loyal knight of mine, Nivien. Trust me when I say that, you'd best take seriously what Knight Seer has to say. Is that so?
What was her mouth?
How nice to meet you, Seer. What is it you need from me?
I draw my sword slowly and deliberately, but it doesn't make a cool sound like I was going for. Sounds pretty pathetic, actually. But I won't be deterred by an embarrassing first impression. Cut the false pleasantries, witch! Release the princess or taste my braid! I use the deepest voice I can, trying to intimidate her, but she just giggles at me. Giggles! A knight threatening her with a sword! Or a knight threatening her with a sword! Yes, she's giggling at me. Yes, okay.
Oh, aren't you two just the cutest little things?
Release the princess from-
Oh, release the princess from where, exactly? I'm not holding her. Don't play dumb.
Release her from her curse!
Oh, that curse. Sorry, little one, but I'm afraid I can't do that.
No more second chances, and no mercy! I swing my sword. Aim high, aim low. Aim high. But Nivien ducks, and my sword sinks into her hat, which turns out to be oddly sticky. My sword!
Thank you, dear Avalon. Do enjoy that treat. I've heard the royal armory uses only the finest of metals.
her hat's a lot- okay.
Anyway, little ones, don't you know bar etiquette? All brawls must be taken outside.
She points to a sign on the wall nearby. It's a common enough rule, so she is probably being truthful, but the sign is so grimy that I can't actually make anything out.
Really, it's quite rude of you to just up and attack without warning. Why, if it weren't for my familiar, I might have gotten hurt. That would have made quite the scene.
Bartender, but they've already made quite the scene. Now that my sword is being slowly ingested instead of swung around, the various patrons have stopped cowering, and the bartender starts towards us with a stern expression. I'm gonna change the voice.
Princess Elderflower, you may be royalty, but you're still beholden to the rules of this bar. Not only has your knight attacked a patron, but aren't you still underage, princess?
Her head bowed, her face hidden behind her hair, and princess nods meekly.
My apologies, sir.
What's the big idea anyway? Nivien didn't do anything wrong. She was here minding her own business when the two of you showed up. That's not true, she- Princess Elderflower grabs my hand.
Knight's here, let's just go.
But-
I think that would be wise.
She leans in conspiratorially, as if she's our friend all of a sudden.
I love my buddies, but this crowd is a bit clicky, and they can get mean after one too many drinks. I wouldn't want the two of you to get hurt now that you're defenseless.
Ugh. The way she's acting so caring and selfless irks me. She just wants to get rid of us! But Princess Elderflower tugs on my hand again, and I remember that her main goal was not to be seen like this. Fine. But I'll be back, witch! You mark my words.
Look forward to seeing you again, little one.
The princess and I are both exhausted by the time we sneak back into the castle. Neither of us had a wink of sleep all night, and with the sun rising, it looks like we won't get the chance. How am I supposed to stay awake while on guard duty now? The princess trudges behind me, keeping her head down like she had had in Bart. Princess, are you alright?
Of course I'm not alright. The royal ball is in a few hours, and I'll have to dance in heels when I'm tired and I'll have to dance in heels when I'm tired and my feet hurt.
What?
And I don't even want to think about looking at my betrothed like this.
Is that... oh no.
Ellie, is that you, my love?
Uh-oh.
Oh, quick, hide me!
Shove her out the window. Stand directly in front of her. Out the window. I yank the shutters closed, just as Princess Rosetta rounds the corner.
Ellie? Pardon me, Knight. Did you happen to see my betrothed near here? I thought I heard her just now. Sounded as though she was rather upset. Is she well?
Apologies, Princess. I haven't seen anyone pass by here. An echo, perhaps?
But I could have sworn... Well, I suppose this castle is rather spacious. Have you any idea on Ellie's whereabouts, then?
Afraid I don't know anyone by that name, Princess.
My apologies. Ellie is my nickname for Princess Elderflower.
Can't say I've heard of her, either.
You don't know Princess Elderflower? Isn't she your employer?
Oops. I'm new here. I actually thought you might be Princess Elderflower. You're so regal and pretty, after all.
Oh, that's very nice of you, Knight, but I don't hold a candle to my betrothed. She has the most beautiful long fluffy hair and amber eyes that you could just stare at for hours.
The rumors are true. Princess Rosetta really is head over heels for Princess Elderflower. I can practically see hearts in her eyes. I feel a bit bad lying to her, but my loyalty, Princess Elderflower, must come first. That does ring a bell. I think I saw her headed into the kitchens. Maybe she's planning on supervising the food for the upcoming ball?
Ah, thank you so much.
She rushes off faster than I thought was possible in such long skirts. Princess, you can come out now. The shutters creak open and Princess Elderflower climbs through the window frame.
You could have let me know that there was a balcony here before you pushed me through the window. I thought I was going to die.
Sorry, Princess. There was no time. But did you really think I would push you through a random window without knowing for certain that there was a balcony there? Nobody would ever do a thing like that. Right? Anyway, she's headed towards the kitchen, so that should keep her distracted for a while. What will you do now, Princess?
What was that you said before about waxing?
well... Waxing is the process of hair removal. Why is this so long? Hair removal from the root by using a covering of sticky substance such as wax to adhere to body hair, then removing this covering and pulling out the hair from the follicle. New hair will not grow back in the previously waxed area for 4 to 6 weeks, although...
Enough!
The princess covers her ears and runs off wailing. Princess? I chase after her, but somehow she's even faster than Princess Rosetta, and she's not even lifting up her voluminous skirts. She runs into her room, slamming and locking the door before I can catch up. Princess? Muffled sobbing sounds from behind the door. I'm sorry, Princess. I'll use a more credible source than Wikipedia next time. Go away! It's probably best to leave her alone for now. But I can't let the princess down in her hour of need. A brilliant idea occurs to me. Now, to begin researching the ins and outs of laser hair removal. It? Wait, is that it? No, there's 4 endings. Okay. Help? Did I ever save? I did save. Okay. I must ask you a question. I must have really upset her. Yeah, we need food and water. What did the princess? Yeah, this is all the same. Power. Wait, aren't I supposed to be the one protecting the princess?
Aren't you supposed to be the one protecting me?
Princess Elderflower has to twist her head around to look at me since I'm crushed directly behind her. Well, you see, Princess, I've never actually seen live combat before.
Look out!
Princess Elderflower tackles me to the ground. The beast thunders past, and we just barely avoid being trampled beneath its feet, or its hooves, or perhaps its paws. Whatever else it might have. I really hope it doesn't have anything else. I don't want to think about the monstrous possibilities. Princess, it's coming for us again. What do we do? I don't want to die.
Oh, for goodness sake.
So a glorious mustache fly by. And here it is, the glorious mustache. Princess Elderflower seizes a nearby stick off the ground. It's Prince. Yes. When the horrible creature turns, pawing the ground as it revs up for another charge, the princess squares her shoulders.
Fetch!
The monster's glowing eyes follow the stick, which sails through the air at a surprising velocity. Miraculously, it turns, racing after stick.
Let's go!
This is natural? No. So, the story is that we are her knight, right? So our princess, Elderflower is her name, and she got cursed by a witch, and the curse was the mustache. And so our story is basically our journey to find the witch and tell her to get the mustache off. Yeah, and we already went through one ending. I guess it kind of ended abruptly, so I'm not sure, but yeah, or basically we were like, oh man, waxing doesn't work, let's go look into laser hair removal, and then the thing ended. Hell yeah. The princess yanks me to my feet and begins to run in opposite direction. Don't have to tell me twice. I follow hot on her heels, wanting to leave the terrifying beast as far behind as I can. Eventually, we slow to a stop, panting for breath.
Oh, you're right, Nightseer.
Who, me? I'm fine, thanks for your quick thinking. Yourself?
Just fine.
No thanks to me, but the princess is too polite to say so. If it works, yeah. Sorry I didn't help much. Princess Elderflower sighs.
No matter. You did warn me that you were a green knight after all. It's my own fault for forcing you to come with me.
Green? I look over my uniform. Oh, I guess I do have some grass stains from when you tackled me to the ground.
Never mind. Come, we're nearly there.
How can you tell?
Listen.
Okay. Oh no, it's live music night, yes. The atmosphere here is really, okay. No pets allow. There certainly is something. Princess Elderflower steps behind me, so close that we're nearly touching. Is she afraid? But she led the way to the forest, and she's well known around the castle for being very social. I notice how she ducks her head, trying to hide her face. Of course! How could I forget? It's shocking how quickly I got used to Princess Elderflower's new facial hair. Really, I don't think it looks half bad on her. But I don't think she'd appreciate me saying so. I pick another topic instead. Okay. This is all the same. There's a karaoke guy, and then the witch shows up! Notorious Witch of the Lake, and amateur mustache stylist, Nivian. She steps closer to us, clutching a half-full glass in one hand, and looking a bit unsteady on her feet. But her eyes are clear as they sweep over the two of us. Okay. Maybe witches have some resistance to the mental effects of alcohol, or maybe she's stone cold sober and she wants us to believe otherwise. Either way, I can't let my guard down. Okay.
Princess Elderflower, I've been expecting you, little one. I had no idea you were such an animal lover. Why didn't you say so sooner?
Huh?
Huh? No need to be honest, little one. My beloveds tell me all about how you played fetch with one of their brothers.
Oh, the monster, right. Yes, this is our witch. This is the one who cursed her. Played fetch? There's no way she means...
It was such a relief to hear. Usually they bring me news of another one of their brethren getting killed. The poor things, they're already an endangered species as is. They can talk. Not to most people, no, but us witches have our ways. Anyway, little one, I'm very grateful to you. Most people who encounter them in the woods attack them without a second thought. Probably because those monsters attack first.
Oh, wait, no, that's me. Probably because those monsters attack first.
Nonsense, they're gentle creatures. They only want to play. And to refer to them as monsters, how crass. They have a name, you know. What was your name again?
None of your business.
Right. Now,
Wait, did she actually fall for that?
The proper scientific name for their species is monster.
What? Isn't that what I said?
Not at all. You said it with such prejudice, and without the capital letter.
Oh my god. Uh-huh.
Nivian.
Although she's still half hidden behind me, the princess's voice rings out strong and firm. We're getting off track. You know why I'm here. Nivian takes a slow sip from her drink.
Do I? Yes, you do. I'm here to ask you to lift the curse you placed upon me. Well, what curse? And what proof do you have that I'm responsible for it?
I can hear you text. She breaks the fourth wall. Oh yeah, she is a witch though.
I'll cut right to the chase, Nivian. You said those creatures are endangered, yes?
Nivian pauses in the act of raising her glass to her lips.
Oh, you seem very confident, little one. Go on then. I can push some legislation that would designate an area of the forest as a sanctuary for them. If it's agreeable to you, you would be appointed the caretaker of the sanctuary, and no one would be allowed to enter the land without your express permission. And of course, it would be illegal to harm the creatures of the land.
I started to feel a bit awkward having both of them look through me at each other to have this conversation. I shuffle a few steps to the side.
Monster sanctuary, hmm? And if a monster were to wander outside the borders of the sanctuary, would the law still protect them? I won't make you false promises. I can't guarantee that I could pass a law that would be that generous to the monsters. So, as the sanctuary's caretaker, it would be your responsibility to keep them safely within the borders. I see.
They both seem to have forgotten I'm here.
Oh, what is it, Nanya? You know you don't need to ask permission to use the bathroom, right?
That isn't... I'm not... Never mind.
You have something to add, Nightseer?
No? Well, it's just... Princess, I know you have quite a bit of political power and influence, But wouldn't building a fence around the sanctuary be rather costly? I can't say I know all the ins and outs of the royal budget, but I'm not sure you would be able to secure the necessary funds.
Well, I could always finance it out of my own pocket.
To my surprise, Nivian waves her hand airily.
Oh, you needn't worry about that, little one. I'm perfectly capable of creating a ward around the sanctuary's borders. A ward would be far more effective at keeping out trespassers than some flimsy little fence, and it's much quicker to construct besides. I can't say I'm entirely pleased with the possibility that more of my beloveds might be killed, but your proposal does seem to be a major improvement over the current circumstances.
Nivian's hat? Makes a noise.
Oh, I'm glad you agree, Avalon.
She reaches up and pats her hat, which bounces in response. Why is your hat moving?
Avalon is not a hat, Nanya. Avalon is a slime, and my beloved familiar.
Less than three.
Now.
She drains her glass before beaming at Princess Elderflower.
I can guess at what you want in return for providing my beloveds with a sanctuary. But lay it out for me verbally, then we'll shake on it. I'll cast a binding spell. A contract of sorts, essentially. That way neither of us can go back on our word.
Princess, are you sure that's a good idea?
Don't be silly, Nanya. I'm a witch, not a demon or a lawyer.
Princess Elderflower takes a deep breath.
I would like you, Nivian, to permanently undo the mustache curse that you've placed upon me. In return, within a week, I, Princess Elderflower, will propose legislation to create the monster sanctuary under the terms that we just agreed upon. And you will do your best to pass it? Of course.
Nivian extends her hand. Princess Elderflower hesitates just a moment. Her eyes slides over to me. So she does remember I'm still here. There's a question in her gaze, plain as day. Is this the right thing to do? I can't say I love the idea of working with one of the most notorious witches in the kingdom. But although she did curse the princess with a mustache, she hasn't done anything to hurt either one of us. Unless you count my pride, that is. And unlike those of a demon or a lawyer, Nivian's terms do sound fair. She didn't even require that the legislation be passed, only that Princess Elderflower try her honest best to do so. Really, Nivian isn't at all what I expected, based on the way my fellow knights talk about her. I think we can trust her. I nod my assistant to the princess. She nods back, then turns to Nivian, grasping the witch's outstretched hand. Oh, it's gone! With her free hand, Princess Elderflower attentively feels her face.
Nivian, thank you.
She moves to pull away, but Nivian's grip on her hand tightens slightly. I tense, reaching for the hilt of my sword.
The truth is, little one, I cursed you because so many of my drinking buddies have been complaining about the monarchy. About my family's rule? Well, the words that kept coming were taxation and infrastructure and healthcare. I can't say I understood it myself.
Oh man.
But they all seemed so distressed, the poor things. I couldn't just stand by and do nothing. I thought that perhaps if I were to inconvenience the royal family somehow, it would make things easier on them.
So you chose to curse me with an ugly mustache.
Ugly?
Huh? Nivian, let's go of Princess Elderflower's hand.
Whatever do you mean, little one? I made certain that your mustache was at the very height of fashion. I'm not cruel. I simply overheard Harry complaining once what a pain it is to groom his facial hair. I thought if you were to spend more time on that, you'd have less time to spend on taxation and infrastructure and healthcare.
I see?
She sees. I certainly don't.
But Nivian, the mustache remained perfectly groomed no matter what I did to it.
Get it now. Seems I misunderstood the effects of the spell. But then, why were you so desperate to remove it? Was it out of fashion after all?
Princess Elderflower looks too dumbfounded to respond. Oh, well, women don't typically have mustaches, you see.
They don't? Why ever not?
They just don't?
Well, strange. I thought the princess looked rather fetching. Sure to turn a few heads her way. Fascinating creatures you are.
Crying emoji?
Oh, don't pout, Avalon. You know you're still my favorite of all the creatures. Well, will that be all then?
I suppose so, yes.
It's been a pleasure, little one. But really, do let the castle know that something must be done about the taxation and the infrastructure and the healthcare. They're making these poor dears miserable.
Oh my gosh. Other people will say I'm pretty girl's handsome, maybe it's like that.
If nothing changes, I'll be forced to take matters into my own hands again. Nivian. Well, if I had a better understanding of what exactly was troubling them, I'm sure I could set to fixing those things.
Oh, if I had- oh, that was Princess Elf. I'm sorry. It's very hard to tell who's talking.
If I had a better understanding of exactly what was troubling them, I'm sure I could set to fixing those things. Is that so? Then I'll see what I can find out for you. Travel safely now, little ones.
The princess and her and I are both exhausted by the time we sneak back into the castle. Neither of us had a wink of sleep all night, and with the sun rising, it looks like we won't get the chance. How am I supposed to stay awake while on guard duty now? But despite the long night, the princess suddenly perks up.
Rosie should be here by now. We must go and find her. If she's already been to my room and found it empty, she might start to worry.
Ellie, speak of the devil!
Is that her? In answer, Princess rushes around the corner.
Rosie!
By the time I round the corner after her, the two girls have one another in a tight embrace.
Rosie, I'm so pleased to finally see you again.
As am I, my love. I've been looking forward to this ball for months. Is that why you're up so early? I was surprised to find your room empty when I arrived.
I don't sleep that late.
Not late, no, but the sun has only just risen. It's usually well on its way to noon by the time you rise.
It's true.
To tell you the truth, Rosie, my knight and I have been all out all night.
Oh.
Finally, she noticed I'm here. Princess Rosetta really does have eyes only for Princess Elderflower. I offer her a respectful bow.
Whatever were the two of you doing that kept you out so late? You must be exhausted, my love.
I'm alright. Princess Elderflower yawns, and Princess Rosetta taps her nose with a fond smile.
Of course you are. Anyway, Night Seer and I were breaking-
Oh my god, I can't- I keep messing up who's talking, I'm sorry.
Anyway, Nightseer and I were breaking a curse.
A curse? What kind of curse? Nothing serious, I hope.
Quite serious, actually. The princess was insistent that the curse be broken before the ball.
Oh, was there some kind of danger?
Well, not exactly. I'd be cursed with an internal mustache.
Princess Rosetta blinks, then giggles.
Oh, Ellie, only you. Well, I do wish that you would have taken a larger escort with you.
Oh my god, bro, the shade.
But as you appear unharmed, I'll spare you the lecture. I take it you were successful, seeing as you appear clean-shaven?
Indeed. Actually, I was surprised at how it went. Oh, surprised how? Well, it turns out the Witch of the Lake is...
A tree hugger?
I think that's a rather derogatory term,
Nightseer.
Although, perhaps not entirely inaccurate. She's quite reasonable, as it turns out.
Witch of the Lake reasonable? We are talking about the same witch who cursed all the houses in your kingdom to insult their owners, yes?
Wait, when was this?
It was about 2 months ago.
Oh, my house... My horse... Oh, my horse, not house. Oh my god. Reading. My horse never spoke to me.
Perhaps that was no curse. I wonder if she didn't just give the mistreated animals a voice.
Sounds like something Nivian would do. So, you made some sort of agreement?
I did. I aimed to propose a monster sanctuary with her as the caretaker.
Monster sanctuary?
No, a monster sanctuary.
Oh, of course, the monsters, with the capital M.
You can hear the difference?
It takes a practice ear. That does seem like it has the potential to be mutually beneficial. Well done indeed, Ellie, my clever princess.
Princess Rosetta smooches Princess Elderflower on the forehead, and she nearly melts into a slime like Avalon.
Oh, I can never be as clever as you, though, Rosie.
Never say never, my love. You may not love to read so much as I do, but you have a knack of negotiation and making people feel at ease. That's a form of cleverness in itself.
I suppose you're right. Now then, I think it's high time for the two of you got...
Oh my god, I keep messing up.
Now then, I think it's high time for the two of you got some sleep.
I told you, Rosie, I'm fine.
Sleep is for the weak! Princess Elderflower yawns again, and her sleepiness is contagious. I try to clench my jaw shut, but a yawn slips through my teeth.
My point proven, I think.
But I need to oversee the final preparations for the ball.
Don't you worry yourself, Ellie. I know your staff, and I know what you like. I'll see it then, and I'll wake you in time to get ready for the ball. I can't have you falling asleep in the middle of the waltz, after all. And you too, Nightseer. A knight must sleep in order to be able to fulfill their duty.
I suppose you're right.
I know I'm right.
You usually are, of course.
Then, Nightseer, you're dismissed for now. We will see you at the ball tonight. Despite the creeping exhaustion, I give her my finest salute. Of course, Princess, I'll be the best perimeter guard on the premises.
I've no doubt. Then, good night, my knight. Sleep well.
And you, Princess. Aww.
Your waltzing has improved since we danced last, Rosie. I hope you didn't spend any sleepless nights practicing.
Only the one. But with you as my dance partner, I won't need to lose sleep to improve. You are the most graceful person I know, Ellie. I can feel it in the way you lead me.
Well, I enjoy dancing, but even more so when it's with you.
I'm glad. I love you, Ellie.
Ah, I love you too, Rosie.
Nivian!
Ah, your love, how cute! Aren't they just the sweetest, Avalon?
Lesson 3.
I'm glad you agree, hehe. Should we give our congratulations to the happy couple? Only for weddings? How strange. Love and happiness is hard enough to find. We ought to be able to congratulate it whenever we feel like it. Perhaps I'll go up and say hello then.
Nivian?
What are you doing here?
And how did you get past the cards?
Just because we have an agreement doesn't mean you can show up here uninvited.
Nivian! You may have tricked me once, but I won't fall for it again! Fleur de Lis Bakery would never hold a buy one get one sale at the same night as this ball. Avalon.
I don't understand all the fuss about us being here when there's so many people already. But perhaps we best make our escape.
On my honor, as a knight, you will not escape the law, witch!
Ugh. How does chasing me around and helping fixing the taxation and the infrastructure and the healthcare?
Okay. Yes, indeed. How does I? Okay.
I guess that's another ending. There's four endings, so we've gotten two. Dude, I'm not quite sure what else. So there was Cower and... Okay, so let me do... I must ask you a question. And then instead of Cower, fight. Alright, and then instead of aiming, I aim high, I aim low. But Nivian takes a casual step back, easily avoiding my swing. Man, fighting an actual person is much harder than wailing on a training dummy.
Come now, little ones. Can't we just have a nice chat?
Not a chance! You lost that option when you refused to lift the curse. Now I have no choice but to force your hand.
Really, you forced Nicaea's hand in forcing your hand. What? Whose hand is being forced?
I'm confused too, but I have to support the princess if I don't say it, so I don't say so. Yeah! I lunge anew with my sword, but Nivian continues to step out of my range, occasionally stepping behind a table or chair to shield herself from my swings.
How ferocious.
She's not even taking me seriously! Irked, I swing my sword in a broad arc. Dude who just almost got stabbed in the eye. Whoa! Oops. Sorry. And then suddenly Nivian's demeanor changes.
Little one, if you insist on using such dangerous weapons indoors, you must take care not to hurt any bystanders with it. Don't they teach you these things at that fancy castle of yours? Or is this what my buddies meant about taxation and infrastructure and healthcare?
What? The princess seems intrigued by all these unexpectedly big words, but I don't recognize a single one of them. Bro, do we not read? Thus, it must be a distraction! I ready my stance again, but Nivian's fingertips begin to flicker with magics.
I don't wish to hurt you, little ones, but I can't have you destroying the entire place. I would hate for this bar to be closed down. It's my favorite one. So, I think it's time for you to take a little nap.
A bowl of light streaks towards me, and I just barely roll out of the way in time. I end up right next to the karaoke guy, who is, thankfully, no longer singing and instead appears to be thinking. Thinking really hard, I mean like, I swear I've never seen anyone think as hard as this guy before. That is, until Nivian unleashes another bolt, and I use him as a meat shield. He promptly falls backwards, forcing me to catch him, and begins to snore.
Oh, night-night, Harry. Sweet dreams. And thank you for catching him, little one. Do be careful lowering him to the floor. Here, I'll even give us a timeout. Oh, I'll even give us a timeout while you do that.
As rude as the witch had been to Princess Elderflower and I, she does seem to really care about the bar's patrons. As promised, she dropped her hands, and the glow of her magic dims. Then, there's no reason not to do what she asks, and take advantage of the breather while I'm at it. As I lower the guy carefully to the ground, I catch sight of a fallen mirror near the back of the karaoke stage. I don't remember hearing glass shattering, so I probably didn't break it. Which is good, because then I'd be on the hook to pay for the damage. But maybe I can use this? At the same time, I see Princess Elderflower out of the corner of my eye. She stands behind the bar, next to the cowering bartender, and her hands is a bottle she pulled down from the shelf. When she catches my gaze, she holds the bottle up, eyebrows raised. Grab a mirror shard, not at Princess Elderflower. I'll save here. Grab a mirror shard. I stand and back away from the soundly sleeping guy, edging towards the mirror. For every step back I take, Nivian takes one forward.
Why so scared, little one? This is a very gentle spell. No nightmares here.
Her hands begin to glow again. Upon close, it's painfully bright, but I force myself to keep my eyes open. I feel around behind me, and my hands closes around the large mirror shard.
Sleep tight, little one.
Nivian releases the bolt of magic, and I thrust the shard up before me.
Oh?
The bolt bounces off, heading straight back and hitting Nivian square in the chest. Her eyes flutter, and she begins to sway, dangerously close to the stage's edge.
Oh, clever. Well fought, little one. I suppose after all that you deserve, a reward.
She mutters something I don't quite catch, and then her eyelids drop and she begins to fall. For a split second, I consider letting her hit the floor. The Witch of the Lake has reportedly caused no shortage of problems for the kingdom after all. But she really didn't seem so bad, so I leaped forward and catched her. Or tried to, anyway. She's heavier than I expected. Ugh.
Snore.
Nivian's hat. Is her hat also snoring?
Nightseer, are you alright?
Princess Elderflower helps roll the witch off me.
I stand dusting myself off. Yeah, I'm... A princess?
What is it?
Your face! It's clean-shaven!
Is it?
Princess Elderflower claps a hand to her mouth.
It is!
Putting her to sleep must have reversed the spell. Oh, putting her to sleep must have reversed the spell.
Nightseer, I can't thank you enough.
I consider Nivian's sleeping form, and her last words before succumbing to sleep. Thank you, Princess, but I'm not sure I can take all the credit. I think when she realized I had won, she chose to do the honorable thing and lift your curse.
Is that so? It doesn't sound much like her, but regardless, I'm just happy to be done with this business. Come, Nightseer, we best hurry back before we're missed.
You got it, Princess. The princess and I are both exhausted by the time we sneak back into the castle. None of us have this wink of sleep. Okay, should be all the same. Yes, and then instead she thanks us. Okay, yeah.
Indeed, it's all thanks to Nightseer for escorting me safely through the forest and defeating the Witch of the Lake. Yep, faced
with my skills, our opponents had no choice but to surrender.
Well, I'm glad you had such a skilled knight at your side, my love. Thank you, Nightseer, for coming to the aid of my betrothed. If any harm were to come to her, I don't know what I would do.
Hey, no biggie. All in a day's work as a knight. This is actually such a biggie. Not one, but two princesses have just praised me. But I can't say so. It wouldn't be cool. And right now, I'm the coolest I've probably ever been.
You mean a knight's work? Huh, Dad?
That's what I said. A knight's work.
A knight's work.
Is she laughing at me?
Oh, Eldie, don't tease the poor thing after all that. You said it yourself. It's thanks to Nightseer that you made it back in one piece.
Oh, all right. Nightseer is just so fun to tease.
Now then, I think it's high time the two of you got some sleep.
Okay, and then this is all the same till the end?
Whatever would they be upset to see us at the... Eldie, it's the Witch of the Lake!
Gods! Seize her! Nivian! You may have tricked me once, but I won't fall for it again! Okay.
Oh, and I'm tight, Avalon.
It's slightly different, but somewhat still the same. Okay, and then instead, nod at Princess Elderflower. I give Princess Elderflower a quick nod, and she steps out from behind the bar, hurling the bottle towards Nivian. Yes, the art is really good. I think the character designs, the art is really good. I'll like sum up a general thoughts about everything, but yes.
Huh? Why you? I know you aren't old enough to drink yet, Princess Elderflower, but even you must be able to recognize what quality vintage you've just wasted. Really, little ones, this has become far too destructive. It's time to put an end to things.
Uh-oh, that can't be good.
Avalon, be a dear and lend me your magic, please.
Slime. Her hat wriggles? Nivian raises her hands again, but instead of forming a bolt of magic, a miasma of blue begins to leak from her palms.
Nightseer, what's going on?
I answer as calmly as I can. Everything will be totally fine, Princess! It'll be totally fine if I can just stop her before her spell takes effect. But my steps toward her are sluggish, and my sword begins to grow heavy in my hands. What have you done to me?
Don't you worry, little one. It's the same spell, just a larger area of effect. You and the princess will be quite alright. You must realize by now that I wouldn't risk the safety of my drinking buddies after all.
She continues speaking, but my heart hearing fails me. Oop. And when Princess Elderflower shakes me awake, the witch is gone.
Nightseer, are you alright?
I'm fine. What about you, Princess?
I'm alright. I managed to avoid her spell by climbing on top of the bar, but I couldn't stop her from leaving. She's long gone now. And though we know this is her favorite haunt, we haven't yet found her home base.
My head is still fuzzy with sleep. Most of what she said goes in one ear and out the other. Meaning? Princess Elderflower sighs.
Trying to track her down again would be a lost cause. I think it's time we admit defeat and return to the castle.
My heart sinks. I failed the princess. Princess Elderflower, sorry.
It's alright. She's a formidable opponent, and you tried your very best.
but it doesn't sound like it's all right. Can you walk?
I think so.
The princess helps me to my feet, and we trudge reluctantly out the door. The princess and I are both exhausted by the time we sneak back into the castle. Neither of us had a wink of sleep all night, and with the sun rising, looks like we won't get the chance. Okay. Princess, are you alright?
Of course I'm not alright. The royal ball is in a few hours, and I have to dance in heels when I'm tired and if my feet hurt. I don't even want to think about looking at my betrothed like this. Betrothed. Ellie, is that you, my love?
Uh-oh.
Oh, quick, hide me!
Yes. Stand directly in front of her. Stay close, princess! I pull the princess into position and stand at attention, just as Princess Rosetta rounds the corner.
Oh, Ellie, there you are, my love. I've been looking all over for you.
So last time I shoved her out the window, so this time I just stood in front of her, so she's actually still here. Okay. How does she know? Behind me, Princess Elderflower stiffens. Okay, not to worry. I can still play this off. Huh? Oh, sorry. You must be mistaken. Princess Elderflower isn't here. My name is Sierra. An easy mistake, don't worry. But I've been told the princess and I look alike.
But she's standing right behind you?
What? No, she's not. Definitely not. You really think a knight wouldn't know if someone would stand behind them? I definitely would. I'm very observant, you know. Princess Rosetta looks past me, addressing Princess Elderflower instead.
Ellie, are you cross with me? Please, whatever I've done to upset you, tell me. Give me a chance to make it right. Oh, Rosie.
The heartfelt pleas of her betrothed melt Princess Elderflower's resolve. She steps out from behind me, head bowed. The gaslighting's real. Gaslighting, but I'm gaslighting myself.
Of course you haven't done anything wrong. You can never. I beg to differ, my love. No one is perfect, but I promise to forgive your mistakes if you forgive mine. Now...
She gives Princess Elderflower's side a playful poke.
Won't you tell me what's bothering you?
Princess Elderflower's giggle fades. She doesn't answer. Princess Rosetta waits patiently. At least 10 seconds, I could never. What? But when Princess Elderflower doesn't respond, Princess Rosetta places her finger gently beneath her chin.
Please, my love, at least let me look at you.
I can see Princess Elderflower trembling, but even still, she lets Princess Rosetta slowly lift her face.
Oh!
Princess Elderflower cringes away, but Princess Rosetta catches her hands, pulling her in close so that they're forehead to forehead.
Aldi, you silly thing. Were you worried I'd be put off by your altered appearance? How did you know? I know you, my love. You do love to fuss about your appearance.
I don't love to, I have to. As a royal, my appearance greatly influences the people's perception of me. And as my betrothed, you would be affected as well.
Oh, but Ellie, you are so beautiful already. I even think you pull off the mustache rather well.
Don't tease me, Rosie.
I'm not. I mean, every word. Not to mention, your people adore you. They'd never turn on you for a little thing like this. Perhaps you'll even start a trend. But since this wasn't intentional on your part, this is the result of a curse, yes?
Yes, that's right. Knight Sia and I went to track down the witch responsible and force her to undo the curse, but we failed.
Then you've been out all night?
Yes.
You must be positively exhausted, my love.
Princess Rosetta kisses her betrothed on the forehead before pulling away.
You ought to get a few hours of sleep before the ball.
I wish I could, but they'll need me to oversee the remaining preparations. Princess Rosetta shakes her head firmly.
I'll have none of that. I've been looking forward to dancing with you tonight for months, Ellie.
So have I.
So, let me take care of the preparations in your stead. Nightseer, won't you escort Ellie back to her room?
It'll make all the kisses more tickly and scratchy. This is true. Hey, but hey, some people do like that. Oh my god, there's an ad! I'ma drink some water.
Oh. My seer, won't you escort Ellie back to her room?
Are we back? Are we back? Are we back? We're back. Okay.
And guard the door. If anyone tries to enter, tell them the princess is feeling unwell and is not to be disturbed.
But Rosie, Nightseer has been awake all night too.
Oh, my apologies, I wasn't thinking. Please feel free to assign another knight to guard her door.
I shake my head. No, I can do it. It's my job as a knight to see this through to the end.
Oh, are you certain?
Yes.
And you, Rosie? Of course, my love.
Very well, then. Princess Elderflower squeezes her betrothed's hands.
Then wake me in time for the ball. I will. Rest well, Rosie. Or, not Rosie, Eldie.
As the night adrenaline fades, Princess Elderflower's exhaustion gets the better of her, and she begins to drag her feet. She's barely conscious by the time we make it to her room. Still, she remembers her manners before she staggers through the doorway.
But thank you for all your help, Nightseer. I appreciate you having you in my service.
I offer her a salute. Just doing my duty, Princess. Rest easy. I'll be here. She yawns, nods, and enters her room, closing and locking the door behind her. As for me, I resolutely take up my post in front of her door. It's only 8 hours or so to the ball. Surely I can stay awake for that long. Sleeps immediately. Oh wait, that's it? Okay. I guess the CG is only on the other one. Okay. I thought there was going to be another dancing CG, but with her and a mustache. I guess not. Okay. I mean, thoughts? Well, first of all, yes, the art's really good. And then the character designs are also really good. Again, it's really short, which is fine because it doesn't have to be long. Right, it's obviously also like a very lighthearted game, and whatnot. But what is it? Yeah, everything's pretty nice and pleasant. And I like the story of, or like the sort of implication, because when the witch is like, oh hey. You know, I gave you a mustache so that eating and drinking would be really hard, ha ha ha. And then Prince is like, what? No, my appearance is awful. And she's like, what? Your appearance is bad? But I made sure your mustache matches it. Right? And then, so basically, and also with Rosie and also the main character too. It seems like only the princess cares about the mustache looking bad. Everyone else is like, you know, you look great. Which I think is really cute. I saw in the extras basically here, because I skimmed the writing, and basically they were like, oh, I really wanted to talk about women with mustaches and insecurities and stuff like that, and how like it doesn't like how they should it should be accepted and it's all fine and good, you know. And yeah, I'm not good at these sorts of things, but yeah. There's also a character art section. Wow, comfy shorts! The mustache's details magically match her outfit. Nivian is not that evil. First name is Iris. This thing is so simple as to show that the source of her magic comes from herself, not the way around. Wow, thoughts. Way older than she looks, or even older than some civilizations. Wild. Her motif is around roses, so yeah, petals everywhere. Where are my glasses? It's taller than Elderflower. Okay. Yeah. I think, yeah, the story is cute. I feel like the endings could be a little bit more ending-like. They kind of end pretty abruptly, even if it is like the last line. Like even just like a black screen and then text that says like the end or like ending one or something like that could kind of hint to like a conclusive thing. I don't know, because without it, it kind of just feels like it cuts off abruptly when we're expecting more. Is there a picture of Cecile? There is unfortunately no picture of Cecile. Cecile is completely gender neutral and also has no appearance, so they can be literally anyone. Oh, right. And I really like Cecile, actually. Sort of like the internal monologue that they have where they're going on about like, oh yeah, you know, I'm a knight, I'm not scared. Sure, I've only been on guard duty, I've never been in a real fight before, but I'm totally not scared. Like, it's very funny to read and makes it very entertaining. I really like those kinds of main characters. Yeah. Yeah. So I did like that a lot. I think the backgrounds I feel like the background for the bar could have been better. The bar was like, because it's princesses, right? And witches and stuff like that. So like all their clothes and everything is very like, you know, fancy. I don't know what you call it. I don't know the correct term for what kind of, but it's like medieval fantasy-ish stuff, right? And like, but the bar was super modern. I don't know, like, I think the castle, the forest were all really great. Those are, the backgrounds are fine. Just the bar is like threw me off so much because it was so modern. For a second, I thought it was a free background, but then when I look on the website, I was like, no, wait, they had a background artist, so it's not a free background. And I was like, what? So did they not, like, so they drew this background for this game with this setting. So, I don't know, it confused me a bit. Maybe that was the direction, or maybe that was the vibe they were going for, I don't know. But it was really modern, especially after wandering in a forest to find a bar that's, like, tucked away, hidden in a forest. I did not expect a bar that's tucked away in the hidden forest to be, like, modern. But, you know, well, yeah. That was that. Oh right, also the GUI, yes. This design, the boxes and everything, the menus, really, really cool. Insanely styled. Very nice. I love the mustache, love the crown and everything. Yeah. So yeah. If I had to nitpick, they had a vibe they were shooting for. Yeah. It's just not the vibe that I thought they were going to go for. Yes, the mustache is so good. Yeah. Those are my nitpicks. My nitpicks is that the ending writing can be a little bit more conclusive. And there could have been a CG with the mustache or with them dancing together. I thought that was going to happen, but it didn't. So, man, it could have been like the same CG and just drew a mustache on top. But yeah, anyway, so the endings was and then plus that one background are my picky complaints. My picky criticisms. That's what it is. Yeah, everything else is very, very good. So cool, cool game. All right, I got a blast because I need to go draw on VStream because I set up a stream for 9:30 for drawing thumbnails. The grind really does not ever stop. So I'm gonna draw thumbnails for the three games that I played today. Alright, cool! Yeah. Thanks for watching and I'll see you later. Bye bye!